Not everybody gave up after Order 66. Once the dust kind of settled, there was one particular Jedi who came back to the Jedi Temple in order to revitalize a newfound Jedi school and possibly a new Jedi Order by training the younglings that had yet to be found throughout the galaxy that were Force-sensitive. Of course, the Emperor and Vader were after this list as well. But today's video is all about Kator, the protector droid that was inside the Jedi Temple. It was Yocasta Nu who returned to the Jedi Temple and entered a secret passage, a secret door that she had implemented inside the library, where nobody could find it. Inside, Kator was still waiting for Yocasta Nu and was keeping everything safe. The monuments, a small ship, Jedi robes, you name it. This was basically a magical museum. Everything that Kator was protecting was a value. Unfortunately, once Yocasta Nu got what she came for, which was the list of the Force-sensitive children, she bid farewell to Kator, who had served her well, but now it was time to split ways, and Kator was left to his own devices. Unfortunately, this would soon come at an impasse, since it wasn't too long that Darth Vader came inside the Jedi Temple, pursued Yocasta Nu, and ultimately found a way inside this secret room of the Jedi Master. Once Vader went inside, Kator did not waste any time. His bioscans indicated that the DNA match was to Jedi Master Anakin Skywalker. Vader at that moment was stunned. If this droid was about to get loose or led to see another day, then he would ultimately reveal his true identity. What's worse, Kator forbid Vader or Master Skywalker, as he referred to him, from entering the room, since his presence in the vault was not authorized. But if Skywalker would like to be granted access, he needed to follow proper procedures from Master Yocasta Nu, and as he was about to finish the sentence, a red blade came swinging at his face, and Kator just simply caught it. This showed us that his instincts were impeccable, moving at lightning speeds. Kator, being the droid he was, he again informed Skywalker that he was a guardian protector of one of the most sensitive areas of the Jedi Temple. He was programmed to defend against any threats to its security. And of course, this included Jedi lightsaber attacks, or perhaps Sith, as Kator was starting to put things together, that Master Skywalker was no longer a Jedi, especially wielding a red blade. Nonchalantly, again, Kator just simply told Master Skywalker that his presence was not allowed. Either he would leave, or Vader jumped at the chance and wanted Kator to die. This was the ultimate strength of the mechanical Darth Vader. One simple punch was so great that the left arm of Kator went flying by, as the shock absorbed from Vader's punch was just too much. But Kator was not frazzled at all. He once again, with lightning speeds, grabbed Vader's right arm with his other hand and proceeded to crush Vader's mechanical hand and mushed it all together. Vader moaned in agonizing pain, but this again would not deter Vader, as with the left hand, he simply punched through Kator's head. This would ultimately do it. The fabled Kator dropped to the floor in complete shambles, and this fight left Darth Vader a bit injured on his hand, but it shows the power of the mechanical Darth Vader, half man, half machine. He destroyed an almighty droid in Kator, a security droid, with simply his own fists and nothing else. Not the Force, and not a lightsaber. Once he was done with Kator, now he again pursued Yocasta Nu throughout the Jedi Temple, and even though I've talked about Yocasta Nu a lot, I wanted to talk about Kator, the aforementioned security droid who is not talked about a lot, but is one of the sacrifices of Order 66 and of the Jedi Purge. You feel bad for the naivete of Kator, who had that sort of K2SO look to him, or feel to him, I should say. The sarcastic nature of his droid non-human-like responses. Once he saw Master Anakin Skywalker enter the vault, as a droid should, he did not let emotions guide him or anything that resemble emotions, since he's a droid. He simply instructed nonchalantly, although he was in grave danger, that Master future Skywalker should just leave or face the consequences. But unfortunately, he would not live to tell another tale, and this is where Kator's story ends. Albeit as short as it was sweet. And as always, it is obvious that Darth Vader does not enjoy getting reminded of who he was. His past will always haunt him, as we've talked about, and it stands to reason why he overreacted later on when, again, the clones found out that he was Anakin Skywalker because they had imprisoned Jacasta Nu, and she spilled the beans, to say the least, telling every clone in that shuttle that they were serving a Jedi. They hated the Jedi, but they didn't even know who they served. This was Anakin Skywalker underneath that mask, and needless to say, Darth Vader took care of business. He completely destroyed that shuttle and killed every clone inside of it. It is apparent that Palpatine gave a lot of influence to Darth Vader when it came time for him to teach the ways of the Sith and the brutal ways of survival. This is the foundation of which the Sith were formed. If we want to go back and use the primary example of how Darth Vader taught the Inquisitors, it's very similar to how Palpatine was a master to Darth Maul. Sidious and Dooku could see eye to eye, as Dooku was already a formidable force user, whether it be Jedi or Sith by his time, but Maul was taught from upbringing by Sidious. He was brutally tortured, and that left the young Zabrak with inner and outer scars. He was a dog that was waiting to be unleashed. Maul hated everybody and everything, but learned to tame that anger. In my mind, this is what Vader ultimately thought would be the best way to approach this, since the Inquisitor would go up against formidable Jedi survivors and probably couldn't fare off against these skilled duelists. It was the only way to prep these young Inquisitors and shape them up into form. This was Darth Vader's way. But of course, I would love to know what you guys think about his teaching methods and who was he inspired by the most. Talk to me down below in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up down below, subscribe for dailies. Now you have an awesome day, Star Wars fans. I'll see you in the next video. May the Force be with you. Until then.